everyone, Conscious back with another tutorial, and today we are going to be working on our player camera. We're also going to do some updates to some world boundaries as well. But the issue that I want to address with the camera is how it just keeps going and it's showing all of the background that we don't want to see. You can just keep going over here, but we don't want that. So it's going to be a couple things we're going to do. The first thing, which is going to be the easiest, we're going to actually delete the camera node off of the player. We're going to add it to the player in the test scene. So now we're going to add a camera 2D here. And the reason that we're going to be doing that is because we're going to need access to this ground tile map for the camera script that we're going to add. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new script inside of our player scenes, our scenes player folder. I'm going to call it player camera. Okay, let's open this up. I'm going to give it a class name, player camera. And we're going to do a couple things here. We're going to add, first, we're going to add an export variable tile map. It's going to be a tile map layer. And I'll explain that in a second, but it will make a little bit more sense when we actually go about this. We are also going to create a method, which is going to be called in the ready, but we're going to call this setup camera limits. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be getting the tile map limits so that we're only displaying the used part of the tile map. So the ground tile map is only going to be this purple, the purple platforms and stuff like that. So it's not just going to keep going and going and going. All right. So the first thing we're going to do in the camera script is we're going to give it a class name. Call it player camera. We're also going to give it an export variable of our tile map, which is going to relate the tile map layer that's on our test scene. So we have here, and then this is going to be able to get access to this ground tile map here. Okay, so let me go back to our player camera script, and now we are going to create a function called func setup camera limits, and it's going to get a rect rect to I, which gives us size and positions, and we are going to get that from here. Setup camera limits. We're going to access the tile map, and then get used rect, just giving us the used rectangle of our tile map, right? Then in there, we're going to set up our camera limits. Where they're allowed to actually view. So we're going to set up the limit left, which is going to equal our rect.position.x. Okay, forgot my colon here. This is going to return void. Still getting an error. And, okay. I didn't extend camera 2D, which is going to be important so we can tap into all of the properties of a camera. Now we're going to do limit right, which is going to be a little bit different. It's going to be the get the rex position dot x plus the rect dot size dot x, and then we're going to multiply it by our by 16, which is our it's the size of our grid, our pixel grid. We're going to do limit bottom, which is the same exact thing here, except it's going to be for the Y. And I'm not going to bother with the top. I just don't think that's necessary here. But if you do, you can go for it. That's totally fine. Now we're going to go back to our test scene and we're going to play it. Okay, this is still incorrect. I did want to make a note. I had to edit this in because I was having issues explaining and my tile map. If you are in here, you can see what I did in the 2D scene. I just added some more platforms to go past this y-axis on our screen. So if you haven't done that yet, do that. But we're still going to have this issue here, right? And I will tell you why. We also want our camera to reposition it back up to our guy's chest. And then I forgot to go into my camera. Sorry, into my, let me save, apologies. Okay, not our test scene, I wanna go into the camera. Okay, let me detach this script. I think something was a little funky here. I wanna do the player camera here. Save this. So now when I click into the camera, you can see that it's looking for a tile map to be assigned. And now we do that. Now when I play it, boom, okay. And if you're seeing this red up here, disregard that. That's what we're getting into next. I did this a little out of order because I was having video issues. Sorry, guys. So the next thing I want to do is I want to make a world boundary, because right now, as you can see, we can still just walk right off and I don't even know where the character is. I can't find him, right? He's just falling. Our bottom doesn't go any lower, so that's it. Our character's gone. For the starts of the level, I don't want him to be able to walk over here. So I'm going to create something that I'm calling a world boundary. And it'll make a little bit more sense when I start building it out. But what we're going to do is we're going to make a new scene. We're actually going to put this in our levels, I think. Yeah, all right. The level script should be in there. We're going to put this in here. We're going to call this scene called world boundary. I'm going to change what this is, what the type is. It's going to be a area 2D, and it's going to need a collision shape, but it's going to need a world boundary, and the collision, it's going to be looking for our player, which is on 5. It actually can also be a layer of ground, which is 9. So let's do that. Go back to our test scene. Pull in our world boundary. We don't have a collision shape, so what we're gonna do is add a child node, add our collision shape. I'm gonna give it a world, I'm actually gonna use a rectangle. We could use a world boundary shape. I was having issues with that when I was doing this prior, so I'm gonna use a rectangle. I'm gonna change the color of this to just show it where, I'm gonna make it red. Just so we can see it, and it will be shown here. So I'm going to just call this, we'll just pull this right here, right at the edge. And now our player will not be able to go off to the left. You know, there's other ways you could do this. We could put up, you know, we could make these have collision shapes and build up something with other different tiles that we have, or add something else in a different tile set, but this is how I chose to do it, and it didn't work, so that's good. I did not set something up correctly. This is on layer ground. Okay, layer 5 is not our player, so that's why. Which one is our player layer? One. I don't know why I made that more complicated than I had to. Okay, it's still not working though, so that's not great. So it's collision. It's looking for ground. We are on a layer here. This is ground. And we have the player here. Ah, I know my mistake. Okay. We're not making this an area 2D. Sorry, guys. We're making this a static body 2D. Now we should be good. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Okay, so now we're gonna make something that I'm calling a world boundary. It's gonna prevent our player from being able to walk off to the left where we don't want him to keep going. So the way that we're gonna do this is, how I'm gonna do it at least, is inside of our levels, we're going to create a new scene, call it world boundary. Okay, we're gonna change the type of this to a static body 2D. Just going to save that. I'm actually going to put the collisions. One is our player. I'm going to put this on 9, which is the ground. He's going to look for the player. Go back to our test scene. I'm going to drag this in here. And what we're going to do is we can just do a, add a collision shape. And we're going to use something called the world boundary shape, which is pretty cool. Let me see if I can, you can see this, right? This is the direction in which it's going to go infinitely. So if we move this here, this will go all the way up and down and detect collisions coming this way. So we don't have to make any rectangle shape or anything like that. This will just go infinitely, right? I'm gonna make this red just so it's more visible for us. And I'm going to turn on the collision shapes in our debug so you can actually see what's going on. So now when we play this, you can see it up there. Our player can't move past this, and that's what's going to prevent our player from actually going off the edge. All right, I think that about wraps up this video. In the next one, we are going to start working on a state machine, and so we can start breaking out our code into more digestible pieces. State machines are gonna be a really important management tool for all of our players' actions. We're gonna be able to break out idle, jump, run into separate states. So we're gonna work on that in the next video. And yeah, thanks for tuning in. Please like and subscribe if you're enjoying the channel.